Okay, so I'm sure you've seen a 3D movie before. In the 3D movie, the picture tends to pop out of the screen towards your eyes, whereas in a 2D movie, the image just stays flat on the screen. Well, have you ever thought about what a 4D movie would look like? I'm not talking about the normal 4D movies at these amusement parks and malls and wherever you see them. You know, the ones where they just move the chairs around, shake them, and, you know, spray stuff on your face, spray water, or whatever it is. I'm not talking about those. I'm talking about actual 4D movies. Scientifically, what is the fourth dimension? Well, that's this video. My name is Murari, and in this video, you're going to visualize beyond the third dimension and into the fourth dimension. So before we get to talk about higher dimensions and dimensions at all, why don't we just try to think about what a dimension actually is in the first place? So what actually is a dimension? So a dimension is a measurable extent of a particular kind, such as length, breadth, depth, or height. So I'm sure you've probably heard this definition before in your physics class, if you're paying attention, unlike me, but it's a really straightforward definition and it gives a good idea of it, but I don't think it gives the full clarity and the full spectrum of what a dimension could be. But in certain movies and TV shows, they show dimension as a different universe or a different reality to ours. So what does dimension mean then? Is it just a different meaning to the word dimension, or does it add to that meaning? And also, what is dimension as in movies like 2D, 3D and whatever? I think that kind of relates to the physics definition of it. In order to truly learn the definition of dimension, I think we all already kind of know it. Because I think this is one of those things where if somebody asks you what a certain word means, you can't really describe it or put it into words exactly how it means, but you know what it actually means. So I think this is a similar situation to that. So I think we all have a similar definition of dimensions in our mind, or a similar idea of what it is. So this is going to be a bit of a different video, and I hope you enjoy. This is the zeroth dimension. Yes, this right here. No, it's not a speck of dust, it's a point. And this point has no dimensions such as length, height, width, whatever it is, weight, volume, etc. This is the first dimension, that is a line or a line segment, and it consists of points. And this is the second dimension. If you draw another line in another direction, that is like the y-axis, and if you combine all of them like this, you'd get a plane, that is a 2D plane, like a piece of paper that's flat and it has two axes, x and y, and in this you could fit some lines, that is one-dimensional bodies. So then what is three dimensions? Well, for three dimensions, you would need to add another direction to both the x and y axis. So you'd add a z axis in this direction that pops out of the plane, that comes out. So this is three dimensional, and in this 3D plane, we can find 2D planes. Like in these three areas, we can have some 2D planes. So now what? Now where do we put the next plane? So what did we do to go from 1D to 2D? We just added a new direction, right? The y direction or the x direction to one of the other directions that was already existing, like x or y. But then again, just like that, how did we go from the second dimension to the third dimension? We just added this z axis right here from the already existing x and y axis. So then what's next? How do we go to the fourth dimension? Do we just add a new direction? Because we can't just do that. Any new direction that you add would just be opposite or in the plane of one of these planes that already exist. So then how do we see in 4D? Well, the answer is simple, and that's that we can't actually see in 4D. The reason being, our eyes can only see objects that are in 3D. Our mind can only visualize what our eyes see. And our eyes have only ever seen three-dimensional objects before. So we can't even comprehend or imagine what 4D would look like. Disclaimer, our eyes can only see in 2D. The way that light and shadows work actually help our brain, our human evolved brain, to percept and visualize what depth is. So a point is the zeroth dimension, a line is the first dimension, and a square is the second dimension. Then the third dimension is a cube, and then the fourth is, well, what happens in the fourth? It's actually called a tesseract. No, I'm not talking about the one from Avengers. I'm talking about a tesseract, that is a 4D cube. and it's also called a hypercube. And since a square has sides and a cube has faces, what would a tesseract have? Well, its surface is something we can't really imagine, so it's called a hypersurface as a whole. And each face you could probably call a hyperface. So if you take a 3D cube and you spread it out, you get six faces, right? How you get a hypercube is you just replace each of those faces with a cube, another cube, and then roll those back onto each other and you get a hypercube. Well, you can't really just roll it because they'd be colliding with each other. But that's why we can't understand what that four-dimensional hypercube would actually look like, because those cubes would just actually combine with each other and form this 4D cube or tesseract. And you could probably say that the tesseract from the Marvel movie is probably brought from this term. Interestingly enough, it is a 3D cube that takes you through space, so maybe it could have to do with the fourth dimension, if there is one in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. So a tesseract is not a 3D object, it's 4D, so it doesn't just rotate, it can also double rotate, and that's about two of its faces or orthogonal planes. And since it double rotates, what you're seeing right now, it also looks like an optical illusion. As you can see, it looks like it's kind of coming out and inside, going back inside on itself, and it looks really weird, but it's very interesting to see that. This is an animation right now, what you're seeing of a hypercube that is rotating in this 3D or 4D plane. It doesn't really matter what the plane is, but as you can see, it's moving in such a way that it's hard for your eyes to even understand what's going on and how it's actually rotating, and it looks like an optical illusion. So the question arises, could there be a 5D cube as well? Well, yes, there could be, because just the same way how you replace the sides of a cube with other cubes and combine them to form a tesseract, you could probably just do the same thing and replace the hyperfaces of a tesseract with other tesseracts or hypercubes, and those would form a pentaract, I guess, a 5D cube, whatever that would be called.
Okay, so imagine that this piece of paper is a two-dimensional universe. As you can see, it's flat. And this is a two-dimensional circle on that universe. So what I'm drawing in this universe right now is actually a two-dimensional organism. So this two-dimensional organism here can see that circle, but it can't actually see the circle as a circle the way that we see it. It would actually be able to see it only as a line. And you know, the reason for that is because even if you looked at it from a two-dimensional view, which would be like this, the circle does kind of just look like a line, doesn't it? All you can see is through this plane of paper. That's how this two-dimensional organism would see that circle, as this line. Now, what would happen if we added something a little bit more complex, like this 3D ball into this 2D plane? What would this person be able to see, this 2D organism? So let's say we just open this portal right here, using magic, or in this case, a scissors. Well, what would happen if we passed this ball through this, and this organism was watching what was happening as the ball was passing through? What would happen? This 3D ball going through this 2D plane, how it would look like for us is just like that. It would just fit through perfectly fine. But this person would be seeing something very interesting while that happens. What this 2D organism would be seeing in its universe when this 3D object passes through is actually a line that actually starts from a little point and starts increasing up to this diameter, the same one, and then it would shrink again to the point. So this animation represents what this 2D organism would be seeing when we passed a 3D sphere through its 2D plane. And that's actually a line that starts off as a point and increases to the diameter of the circle, and then decreases again and back to a point. So it expands from a minimum size to a maximum and then back to a minimum as the ball goes out, or the sphere comes out of the 2D plane. So as we saw, the 2D organism had 1D eyes. The reason why I'm saying 1D eyes is because it could only see points and lines, like how the circle was just viewed as a line. The same way we also have 2D eyes, even though we're 3D. So I prepared this chart here. As you can see, there's kind of a pattern. Even a 1D organism that would be living in just a straight line, it would have 0D eyes, because all it could see is the points in front of it or behind it in that line. So if there was 4D organisms, they'd have 3D eyes, and they would actually be able to perceive depth, unlike how we just use our brains to visualize what shadows and light work like. It is my speculation that since we live in a 3D world, maybe, and this is a big maybe, every object and everything we see in this world could have four-dimensional properties. Since our minds can visualize and feel and sense that objects are actually in 3D, maybe we just aren't aware of the fourth dimensional properties of an object. Maybe a 4D, 5D, or some kind of higher or supernatural being, if they were to look at any normal object in our world, maybe they could see the fourth dimensional or higher dimensional properties of it.
So after hearing all of this, some of you might get the doubt, is there a fifth dimension? Theoretically, yes, there could be a fifth dimension. The same way there's a second dimension inside a third dimension, and the third dimension inside the fourth dimension, there could also be the fourth dimension inside the fifth dimension, and the sixth inside the seventh, and the seventh inside the eighth, the 99th inside of the 100th, and so on. It could go to infinity and beyond. So if I were to draw a square and a circle inside of that on a paper, you as a 3D organism would be able to see the circle inside the square. But a 2D organism on the paper next to the square, like somewhere outside of it, wouldn't be able to see that there was a circle inside the square. So as 3D organisms, we can see everything. The same way 4D organisms can also see what's inside a 3D on a normal box, what are the contents of it. So just like that, a 4D organism can see everything that's in this plane. And similarly, we could say a 5D organism is also able to see inside a 4D box, I guess, or throughout everything inside a four-dimensional plane. So I think that just gives proof that mathematically or imaginatively, there could be a fifth dimension and more spatial dimensions, an infinite amount. So what we talked about so far concerns dimension as a spatial property. But there's a common idea that the fourth dimension is actually time. If you've seen in the movie Interstellar, at the end how he goes into a black hole and they show physical time as a dimension, and he goes through that and whatever, you get the story. So is this true? Well, I think in my opinion it's merely just an idea, and that too an abstract one, because time exists in all dimensions, whether you're in 2D, 3D, 4D, time still moves forward and at the same pace. I think time is a very different and abstract concept conceived by humans, and it's a very interesting phenomenon that keeps going in the same direction and never really changes. The only times when you can see when time changes is when you're going near the speed of light or really fast away from Earth or something, and the moment you come back to that place and stop moving at that speed, you'll find that time has sort of sped up for you and was going at a normal pace for everyone else. So you'd actually have traveled forward in time technically. Time is mostly just a constant phenomenon that humans have come up with, I think. And it's just a very abstract idea that humans got, and I think that's why the human race is so amazing. So we could have questions like, do 4D objects exist inside of our universe? Or what about outside of our universe? Or do they exist in black holes? Well, nobody knows. And I hope humankind does get to know in the next million or billion years. And that would be a very interesting answer. So that's it for this video. And I hope you enjoyed. I hope you want to watch more. I tried to make this video as good as I can. Better than before, at least. I hope there's an improvement. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed. Bye.